Hi, I'm Warren Yates at yatesbanjos.com, and today I want to give you some tips on shipping your banjo to reduce the chance of having damage. The thing to understand that is most likely to go wrong in a banjo is to understand the mechanics of the way the banjo is designed. So if you think about where's the weight of the instrument, is the pot. And the pot has a rim, tone ring, all of the hardware, the flange, but it's only held by four and sometimes three little L brackets. The L brackets, a very thin piece of sheet metal, they attach to the rim with two little screws. There's four, if not three, and all of the weight is tied onto this. Well, these L brackets now lay over onto the resonator, and little thumb screws hold them in there. So in effect, it is suspended inside the resonator. So when you put a banjo in a case that is now, the case is deceiving because it's very snugly, I guess is the word, holds the resonator in the case, so it gives you a little bit of false hope. Well, that is true. It does hold the resonator. But then this big heavy mechanism that's mounted inside the resonator is where all the mass is. And just like in physics, force equals mass times acceleration. So the heavier it is, the faster it's dropped, the more force you're going to have on those little L brackets. When they get to the point they can no longer take the load of that initial force, which it may be dropping the case 2 feet from the ground up or up down. Normally don't just fly off the floor, but it'll come out of your hand and it'll hit the ground. So what'll happen is the resonator gets held nicely and the rest of the banjo goes through it. Then what happens is this flange right here is the first thing to touch the thinnest place on that resonator and it goes through it. If they drop it on the head, this banjo is going to just destroy that end of the resonator. If it's dropped on the side, it's going to destroy this. You're going to break the screws loose where the L brackets are. If it's this way, you're going to drop that. And sometimes, because these flanges are made out of such thin material, and they have to be for the design and sound, you'll hit it hard enough to break the flange. Now, if you've got a lot of money tied up in your banjo, some of those parts might not be available. And you certainly don't want to pay the price for them if they do. The neck generally will hold its position, but there's so many times because the whole, there's a weak joint right here in the neck that because by the time you get the hole drilled for the truss rod, that's a very thin place. If it hits just right, it will snap that neck right off. And there are situations to where however they drop it, from whatever distance, whatever they do, it will break the neck completely in half. So anything can happen. And the people that, the carriers that carry your instrument, they don't care anything about whether or not your instrument is taken care of. Their job is to get the package from point A to point B. You can buy insurance that will cover your instrument, but it's very much a false hope because if they look into it and they say, well, we didn't see it when you packed it and it looks like it was damaged before it was ever shipped because the box, it looks like it might have been dropped, but there's no damage, no puncture or anything like that, they'll deny your claim and you don't get your insurance money back either. Insurance is good to put on there because if they pay, of course, don't charge them for a new banjo, charge them for the repairs, unless it's just absolutely destroyed. But if they lose it and can't find it, it goes off the radar and never shows up. Well, they have no choice but to pay for the full amount that the Banjo costs. So insure it for what it takes to replace it, and that's all the recourse you've got. Now, knowing that that is the case, that you're already entered a battle that you're on the losing side, it's going to be your responsibility to pack that instrument in a condition that they would have very much of a hard time tearing it up. So I'm going to show you some techniques to use to keep them from destroying your equipment. We've got the Banjo in the case that it's going to be shipped in. And if you'll notice, it looks like it fits. I mean, it just is very well to protect. Now, you can spend a lot more money on cases, and it's like you can park your truck on one of them. Well, if you don't typically park your truck on your Banjo, I don't know that I would spend my money in that way. We're not likely to have elephants to come and sit down on them, so I think that might be a little exaggerated. Oh, it'd be nice to know that it can, but I wouldn't, if that's the only sales that you're presented, I wouldn't worry so much about that. What's going to happen is they will get dropped. So if they drop, then this whole mass gets pushed into the resonator. Once the weight goes over, the resonator tries to stop it, but the Banjo keeps going. So expensive case, cheap case, you've still got the Banjo itself that in its design is not such a good shipping type thing. Now, a guitar and mandolin is a whole different story. There's no internal parts that move. You can do no telling what, and the case will really work great. But a Banjo, they are plagued with problems. So, now I've got to ship this Banjo, but normally when I have a strap on here, what I do is I fold them to where I wrap them around this way. Okay, it's inside there, it's protected. Now I can close it and I can carry it around wherever I need to go. In this case, I'm going to be putting wedges inside here, and I don't want to ruin this person's new strap. It needs to look new when they get it. You pay a lot of money for something, it deserves to be taken care of. So I'll find some kind of way to put it across or something like this, maybe up under the fifth peg or something like that. Then I've got room to be able to get my wedges around. I've used a lot of different things for spacers, and the best thing that I've come up with lately, until I see something better, I'm going to stick with this. I find this thick pipe insulation like this, and no, I'm not going to do this. I'm going to show you what I do. This is a good thick piece. It's the only thing I knew to find. And it's about equal to what a kid would play with in a swimming pool, same type of material. It's just that it's pipe insulation. So you wrap it around a pipe and glue it up and it's insulated. But this is not rubber. It's some type of foam plastic or something like that. It's very hard to pinch. And I don't see a label. I don't really know what it's called. But I don't know if you can read that number, if it'll tell you anything or not. I'll see if there's another one. Yeah, here's another one. Maybe you can get something off of that. But anyway, I got it at the local Ace Hardware. They carried it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bandsaw some strips off of here, creating blocks so I can stick it in sideways. So, let's see what happens once I get through cutting it. Now, I've gone over to my bandsaw and I cut these things. Now, you may have a handsaw or a knife, whatever works for you. And before I start inserting these in, there's another thing that's important to do. So often when you ship a Banjo, the thumb screws will work themselves loose, and then if they get under the resonator, then you've got a defect resonator by the time you get it. So I don't understand exactly what happens in shipping. You can put a Banjo in a car, and you can carry it all the way across the United States, and this is the same condition when you get there as when you left. But you put it in the back of a carrier's truck, and you can't get next door without everything falling apart on it. Different frequency of vibration or something, I don't know. But to keep these things from coming loose, you know, I put rubber bands from one to another. And if my rubber bands are too small, then I'll just basically put two of them together until I've got one. So I'll stretch it across that one. I'll stretch it across that one, and I'll make up two more. I'll put it together and make a long one. I'll go on the back side, and just in case one of them were to happen to pop off for whatever reason, I'll go ahead and go across this inside. In order to get that going. Now it's time to install my little blocks. And when I get them cut out, they kind of look like little roller skate wheels or dragster wheels for a toy or something. I don't know. But the thing is they're very hard to compress. So like I say, it's not the soft rubber kind. This is a foam looking material. You see a lot of air holes in there, but it's real tough. So what I'll do is I'll pick a spot, maybe I'll start up here, and I'll put it under. I don't want to destroy the case, but I'd rather the case get a little damaged than anything to ever happen to the Banjo. Cases are cases. They're made to take the abuse, not the Banjo. So I'll wedge it in, push it against this part of the tension hoop, because I'm trying to capture and isolate and suspend that center piece. Well, if I put this one in, I might as well go back here, roll that one under. I'll go up here and usually the one around the armrest is a little tighter, so I'll put it in first. And this in, and then I'll just try to fill up all the spaces all the way around that I can. I don't want to damage that strap, but there again, it's more important to get it there than to worry about something that's going to look old quick anyway on an old looking Banjo. You know, who would figure? So yeah, you know, you pick the battles that you want to fight, I guess. Okay, so you see I'm starting to fill it up all the way around. If you have to cut one thinner to go around something like the armrest, that's fine. Don't put one behind the tailpiece because you don't want to push on that. You want it left alone pretty much. Okay, so, you know, it looks like a head with the old-time curlers stuck in their hair, but, you know, they show so much on the old TV shows. But that's about as many as I can put in there. So now I want to be able to close it, and I want to be able to make sure that the Banjo doesn't pop up, because if it does, it can knock all my little wedges out of it, and I want those to stay in there. So basically I'll put one up on the top of the fingerboard, right in that one place only, and then I'll see if I can close it. Okay, that's a little tight right there, so I don't want to damage the lid, so I cut a smaller one. Now, do keep in mind what I was trying to achieve here is when I put these in here, I'm keeping the pot suspended. So basically, the resonator, if in a drop, it might never hit the edge of the case, which is exactly what we want. If it touched a little, it's okay, but we really want to keep it suspended separately. So let the outside of the case do the holding, not the resonator. So I put a thin one up here. Let's see if I can close the lid. It looks like I can make that one work. So I'll come up here, and the latches that will allow me to at least put the hook over it, I'll go ahead and do those to give it the idea that it needs to start conforming to what I'm getting ready to put it under. And of course, I don't want to destroy anything, but I've got to give it all of the effort that I can. If you'll notice, I didn't take the strings down or change the bridge. Chances are, when the customer gets this banjo, it's going to be still in tune when they pull it out of the box, because I didn't do anything to mash against the string bridge or the head. Okay, at that point, that is as well packed inside there as you can possibly get. Now, so many times people will take, say, like a wad of paper, and they'll wad it up real tight, and they'll lay it around in there. The only thing that you do when you do that is you take up space. You don't create that isolation of one loose part up to a solid part. So you really have to think about, if this was a motor mount to a car, would it hold that motor steady? If you put the piece of paper around there, are you isolated or are you solid, hook the motor to the car frame, or did you simply stuff some paper down in the fender well? You got to think about it in that respect. Now, the next part of being able to ship the banjo, once that you have taken care of it inside of the case, you've got to take care of it in the size of the box. Now, don't take a box that is well oversized, as it should be, and cut it down to try to save that little bit of shipping. That little shipping will get it torn up, because it's one of those things that, again, now the banjo case needs to be suspended inside of all of its packing inside the box, so that if it's dropped, it has some bounce room. So I got to make sure that what little bit that I have here, maybe 5 inches, I've got to get half of the padding down at the bottom and half of it at the top. And then I want to make sure that, because I've got a couple of inches on each side that I can split, then I get something down inside there. So one of the tricks that I do is, of course, now let me back up a second. What somebody like UPS or those kind of people, they're going to want you, as far as their standards, and this is the best way, to take bubble wrap, wrap the banjo around totally solid, very well, tape it off, and cover it from one end to the other. I'm talking about across the top, everything. So it's totally isolated. Put some packing peanuts down in the bottom of the box. Put your banjo down in it, and then fill it all the way up with packing peanuts, and make sure that it's jiggled everywhere that you can jiggle it. And that's a step in the right direction for getting to collect a claim, because if they look at it and say, oh, it doesn't look like it was packed right, well, whatever their standards that are going by that day is going to determine whether or not you get anything out of it. Okay, so what I do is, when I have my cases shipped to me by a company, they have this leftover foam that they make cases out of, and I said, look, instead of putting it in your dumpster, what about put it in my cases? I said, just pack everything in that case that you can and let me dispose of it. Hey, that's great, you know. So what I'll do is I'll take something like, say, these squares right here, and I'll let that remind me that that's the front side of the banjo. You don't want to put the banjo in upside down or something. You want to know that the light side is to your mark, or whatever you can use as an identifying mark. And you want to know that when you pack it all up, you remember that. So when you put the label on the box, that the top side of the banjo is up. Whether it makes a difference or not, I feel better about it, so that's what I recommend. So I'm going to put a layer of this foam down in the bottom, so I get about 2.5 good inches after it's compressed lightly. And of course, it's all kind of odd shaped, so there's no telling what it's going to look like, and I know about how much to put in there in order to achieve that. And the true test is once I put the banjo in there, if I've got about 2.5 inches on the top side, then I'm there. Okay, I still would feel better if I have a little more in there, so. Okay, that being the case, I've got enough that when I compress it, I should be where I need to be. Now, I've got the open lid portion out, because I'm going to keep up with where that is. Times like now is when it would really be handy to have a much bigger shop. Okay, so that's, okay, I've compressed it down a little bit. So now by the time that I've got my other stuff on top of it, then I'm good to go. So I'll take more of this foam, and I got to think about the edge of the banjo. I got to pack it too. So I'll pack some stuff down in it, because I'm going to take something and push it down in there to make sure that it's wedged into place. Now, when they send me foam, it's not enough, but I can come up with enough other packing material to be able to make up the difference. So, I'll now take a thin stick, and I'll just go in here and push it down in those corners to where I feel like that I've got the protection where I need it. In other words, it's not going to just fall out. And if you have any packing peanuts, by all means, pour them in there. So now I've got that part of it isolated. So I have to think about now, well, I don't really have anything out here. Well, I'm going to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some pieces and slide down in front of it. And I'm going to push those down at least halfway or down to the area that I think that it needs some protection. And I'm going to take that same stick and I'm going to wedge it down there. And the box will swell out just a little bit. That's okay. I mean, you don't want it round like a drum. But you got to make sure that you've got some kind of protection in there. And if you have to pay for a little wider box to ship, then so be it, you know. But also use a very good quality box. If you've got a box that's so flimsy, it's barely holding together, don't use it. Go buy one. Somewhere like the UPS store or somewhere like that, they'll sell you a good one. They'll even pack it for you if you want to, but they won't pack the inside of your case. Now also, if you have them to ship it, they might not stand for anything more than $1,000 in insurance. You got to think about that. If you need $5,000 worth of insurance, then you might need to do it on your own. But it sure is nice to say, you know, I bought the stuff from them to pack it correctly, and they sold me the right stuff. Okay, so now down the sides, I think that I'm well protected. So I got to get something, fill up these holes so that the new packing I put in there doesn't get lost. Now at this point, you know, paper does work good. You want something clean, you know, somebody break it out in their living room, you don't want to be on the bad list from now on. Of course, I got to open up and make sure what I'm sending them. Send them a bunch of onions that's going to rot or something. So I'm just simply taking up space. I've got enough distance that there's nothing going to crush that and cause me any problems. Okay, so now I've got some pieces of bubble wrap here and I'm going to lay across the top of it. And make sure that some of it goes down in. If I can push a little down each side, that's good. And I've been saving this real good piece of bubble wrap right here that's real thick to put on there so that get that little extra. Okay, and it should be fairly difficult to close the lid at this point. Okay, so either I'm going to peel the old label off where they shipped me, or I'm going to fold it to the inside and cover it up. You never want to leave any existing labels on there, because you might find out that they read it wrong and shipped it to where you bought the case from, or ship it back to yourself. Yes, I have had packages show up on my own door just in time that where I'd shipped it 2 days before. Now the customer's waiting on it. It can happen. So I don't want to skimp on the tape. I spent this much money and time making sure that everything is done as properly as I can. Tape is not the place to skimp on it. So, pull it together good and tight, get it started. I'm going to make quite a few passes of different directions if I can get the tape to work with me. I know some of you are going to say, well, why don't you use a tape gun? I ain't never got one to work right. So I end up taking it out of the tape gun to do this, so. Now, I'll just kind of pick a spot and start lapping things together. I like for it to overhang, because then I can pull a little more pressure in that direction. Tape across it. The last thing I want it to do is come out of this box in shipment. I don't know what their technology for tearing things up is, but they have it, and they're good at tearing them up. So it's my job to reduce the odds. Might be overboard, but as I said, compared to a damaged tape, is cheap. And I like to go around like this in order to kind of tie the tape together. That way, if one comes loose, well, it's got to break the other piece before it can go anywhere. And of course, just because you picked up a box and the bottom was together, that does not in any way mean that the bottom was a good job. So turn it over and tape the bottom as well, just to be sure. Okay, now, I should be able to bounce it, and look, the box will actually bounce off the floor a little bit. That tells me that that will absorb quite a bit of shock, because the case is bouncing before it ever affects what's on the inside of the Banjo. So the last thing to do is, now I know, I remembered these squares was my reference point. If I didn't have them, I would have drawn something on there. Label here, X, I don't know. So when I get my label drawn up, wherever I get it from, or if I print it off computer and tape over it and get it on there good and solid, I'll put it on the flat side of the box. Because in most cases, when a case is going down the conveyors of the carrier, their readers read from the top down as it passes through to keep track of where it is in location. Well, if you put it up on the top, and all of a sudden it's up on the two-story conveyor, and something hits it, it's liable to tumble down and break, and maybe that's where it comes from. So make it to where if it reads from top down, they have no choice but to lay it flat. And you want the right side of the banjo up. So that guarantees pretty much that it's in the right place at all times. Put it to the top size so that when the delivery man looks at it, he puts it on his truck. He does it so he don't have to bend over and the heavy part is to the bottom. You can tear one up if you put the heavy part of the banjo up here and then it falls over. Well, now you've got a 3-4 foot drop that you have to deal with and you'll probably damage it that way. So the weight on the bottom label up here guarantees that to make it easy for them, it stays that way. So I think that that's all I've got, and happy packing, and make it easy on you and the receiver by doing the absolute best way you can, and don't totally trust your insurance, but have it just in case, because who's to say they may lose it, and if they can't produce it, sound like a good case for paying the full amount to me. Y'all take care.